All right, Shalom. We are the Hebrew Israelites from the Indianapolis camp of the Great Millstone, and we're here to give all praise and glory and honor to
Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Rakakadash.
Double honor to the apostles and elders of the Great Millstone who rule well and teaching us this 100% truth. Salutations to them and our fellow Achim who labor in this truth week in and week out on the highways and byways. Also, salutations to the scattered 12 tribes of Israel, scattered to the four corners of the earth that be like unto the speckled bird. To you we say Shalom, and the scattered 12 tribes of Israel are as follows. The tribe of Judah, the so-called Negroes. The tribe of Benjamin, the so-called West Indians. The tribe of Levi, the so-called Haitians. The tribe of Simeon, the so-called Dominicans. The tribe of Zebulun, the so-called Guatemalans, the Panamanians. The tribe of Ephraim, the so-called Puerto Ricans. The tribe of Manasseh, the so-called Cubans. The tribe of Gad, the so-called North American Indians. The tribe of Reuben, the so-called Seminole Indians. The tribe of Naphtali, the so-called Argentinians to Chileans. The tribe of Asher, the so-called Colombians to Uruguayans. And the tribe of Issachar, the so-called Mexicans. Do you say Shalom?
Shalom.
Just going to get right into it with an open forum.
The book of Jeremiah chapter 10 verse 1. Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you, O house of Israel. Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, for the heathen are dismayed at them.
Hey, at the beginning it says, hey, hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you, O house of Israel. So the children of Israel, hey, the brother just broke down the 12 tribes. Now that's who this word and these scriptures are geared towards. You Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man.
Huh.
Alright.
Okay.
Go ahead, read verse 2.
Verse 2. Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen and be.
That's right. Learn not the way of the heathen. The heathen, what? Are the non-Israelites, all right? This is other nations, man. It's 18 nations. So 17 of the nations, man, are the heathens, all right? So learn not the way of the heathen. So right now, we're in the midst of what? 4th of July, Independence Day. Independence for who? Esau, Edom, all right? This has nothing to do with Jake. He's Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, man. All right.
Con.
That was an example.
Yeah, if we just add to that, you know, our people, our ancestors were still slaves, you know, when that so-called Independence Day was established, okay? So, yeah, we weren't considered citizens, you know, less than cattle, three-fifths of a person, okay? So we should not be celebrating this holiday, all right?
That's right.
It says, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, for the heathen are dismayed at them.
Right, be not dismayed at the signs of heavens, like the chariot sightings, all right, the new moons and blood moons and the harvest moon, all these different signs of the coming of our Lord Yahweh Shem Yahshua, all right. Hey, the heathen dismayed because they weren't given the intellect to follow these laws, statutes, commandments, and to understand what's coming back, all right. Hey, see, in the middle of the world, we ain't shook by that, man, because we got Yahweh Shem Yahshua protecting us, man. So I'm sure you heard that explosion, right? What that precept there?
This is Proverbs chapter 3, verse 31. Envy thou not the oppressor, and choose none of his way.
That's right, envy not. So, hey, someone get the definition for envy real quick. So envy not the oppressor, or choose none of his ways, all right? So anything that that these other nations that are pushing, all right, the way their lifestyles work and how they live on the day-to-day, we shouldn't be following after them. We shouldn't be looking at them at all like, wow, man, those nations, man, they know how to get down. No, you know, we're the children of Israel, man. All right, we got the true living power, man, all right? These other nations are stuck onto idols, you know, that can't breathe or have no life in them, man, all right?
Painful awareness of another's possessions.
See? Right, possessions, right. And what these heathen nations have on this side is these carnal possessions. All right, they have the bigger and nice homes, you know, the nice vehicles, all right? Your quote-unquote prestigious jobs, all right? But at the same time, hey, all this is going to pass away, man. So you can't be in awe to these heathens, man. Because what we have coming to us is going to be way greater. It's going to far exceed anything that we've been able to see in these current times, right?
Advantages,
mm-hmm.
Or a desire to have them too.
That's right, because technically, man, we're under these curses, and we're in a punishment, man. Hey, when your parents, man, tell you, hey, you can't play the game or go outside, man, you're under punishment. All right, and then you go against their word, and you go out and guess what? Do the things that your parents told you not to do, man. All right, that's like you envying these other heathens, and you want to go on to them, be like them, be like, hey, they're getting it now, man. So I'm gonna join up with them and connect with them, and I'm gonna do what they do, so I can be at the position they are. All right. Well, the Lord tell you not to do those things. All right.
That's what covetousness.
Covetousness. Right. So we're not to be covetous, we're not to be wanting what they have, all right? Because what we're going to have requires patience, but it's going to be far exceedingly greater, all right?
Verse 32, for the froward is abomination to the Lord Yahweh by Shem Abishai, but his secret is with the righteous.
That's right, kind of get that word froward too, all right, for edification. Read that one more time, sorry.
Proverbs chapter 3, verse 32. For the froward is abomination to the Most High, Yahweh Bashir Abishai, but his secret is with the righteous.
That's right. Hey, his secret is with the righteous. Ultimately, his elect and his prophets, as it says, the Amos 3 and 7, anybody wants to tell? And go ahead on that froward.
Okay, froward. Habitually disposed to disobedience and opposition.
So read that one more time.
Verse 32. For the froward is abomination to Yahweh Bashir Abishai, but his secret is with the righteous.
That's right. So that definition.
Okay. Right. Habitually froward. Habitually disposed to disobedience and opposition.
That's right. That's right. Hey. You against the Lord, man. Hey, that's why they call the children of Israel a rebellious nation, man.
God. All right.
You know?
It says habitually, which means it's continuous.
That's right. That's
you know,
right.
It never stops.
That's right.
Because you got people that's habitual liars.
That's right.
Esau is just
Verse 33. The curse of Yahweh by Shem Abishai is in the house of the wicked, but he blesses the habitation of the just.
Now one more time, son.
Proverbs 3, verse 33. The curse of the Lord is in the house of the wicked, but he blesses the habitation of the just.
That's right. Hey, he's going to curse the wicked, man. Hey, the ones that are contrary to his law, statutes, and commandments, to the ways of Yahweh by Shem Abishai, man. And he's going to be with his men, man, that are standing boldly for these law, statutes, and commandments, man, that actually put the Father in front of their day-to-day living, man. All right? But the only people that are going to have that is the children of Israel, all right? Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, right? Those are the ones that can only be just, okay? They have the opportunity to be just, all right?
The curse of the Lord is in the house of the wicked. What's the ultimate curse? The thermonuclear missile.
That's right.
It's in the house, in the what? The lineage and habitation of Esau, man. That's the number one wicked, as well as the rest of his family. Even you Negro and Latino Native Americans, two-thirds of Israel, you're part of the house of the wicked too, man, because why? You follow the ways of the heathen. You know what I'm saying?
Go ahead, bro.
Yeah. This is Psalm 37. I'm starting at verse 1. Fret not thyself because of evil doers, neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity. For they shall soon be cut down like the grass, and wither as the green herb.
That's right, because like all these things that we see today, man, are going to pass away, man. All right, ultimately, with the thermonuclear destruction that constitutes the place for the chariots, man. Because this is only for a moment, man. The children of Israel are going to have a life of forever, all right, man, to live what our best lives, right, through righteousness, man. All right, while everyone else is trying to get it now, man, the men of the Lord are going to be patiently waiting, man, for the day, for our day, man, you know, for the day of the Lord, man.
Yeah, you see Esau with the big houses and the Bentley trucks and the BMW motorcycles, but as a man of the Lord, you should be envious of what they have. You know what I'm saying? Why? Because we got promised to us salvation.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? We're going to have chariots, man.
Right,
you see what the angel, the fearful, the angel of the Lord can do? You know what I'm saying? Esau just shot a missile, had four chariots of the Lord, and look what happened.
Yeah.
Nothing happened. Don't you want something like that instead of a Lamborghini? You know what I'm saying? I know I do.
Yeah, I do too. Yeah.
You know?
Proverbs 24, verse 19. Grant not thyself because of evil men, neither be thou envious after wicked. For there shall be no reward to the evil man, the candle of the wicked shall be put out.
That's right, hey, the candle of the wicked shall be put out, and the ultimate wicked is Esau Edom, man. You so-called white people, man. Alright? Hey, and you two-third Jakes, man, that follow behind that, alright? Hey, you're gonna actually be put out, man. You're gonna have to be put to death, man. Alright? Because you, hey, especially the two-third Jakes, man, because you're not in your right mind, man, you're not going to be born back into the kingdom, man. But Esau, either man, isn't going to make it, man. They're going to be ultimately cut off by slaughter, man. All
right.
I got two
seconds. Said the Lord going to put the candle of the wicked out. You know what? The Lord going to punch your lights out.
Man. That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Esau, either is going to be ultimately destroyed, man. You and your household. Right. You and your lineage, like scripture say. Leave neither root nor branch.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
Verse 21. My son, fear thou Yahweh, should I was shy, and the kings, and meddle not with them that are given to change.
Mm.
For their calamity shall rise suddenly, and who knoweth the ruin of them both?
That's right. Oh, go ahead, bro.
You read
that? Yeah, go ahead. Read that over. Yeah. Thank you, all right.
It's Proverbs 24, verse 21. My son, fear thou the Lord, Yahweh, Shem Shai.
He said, my son, by the way, hey, he's still talking to the children of Israel, man. All right. We're the only ones that can be sons unto the Heavenly Father, man.
Sure. All right,
because he chose this, through Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, man. All right, and you got your 12 tribes of Israel, man. We're his sons, okay? Right.
He says, fear thou Yahweh, Shem Shai, in the king, and meddle not with them that are given to change.
Mm-hmm.
For their calamity shall rise suddenly, and who knows the rule of them both?
That's right. It's like, because ultimately, hey, Yahweh Shema Shah's in charge, man. This is his movie. This is his script, man. All right? And he knows the end of the wicked, man. All right? So, hey, hearken unto his words, man. That's his arm stretched forth out to you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. So, hey, don't worry about all these things that are in this world, man. Because these are gonna go away, man. Follow me, and I'll show you how to actually live the salvation and righteousness, but you know what that really is—a true kingdom, man. All right.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 23, verse 17. It says, "Let not thine heart envy sinners, but be thou in the fear of the Lord all day long."
That's right. Hey, it's envy not the sinners, but be in the fear of the Lord all the day long, man. That means what? How do you feel the Lord every day, man? Hey, you constantly examine your day-to-day life, man. You know, through these scriptures, all right? Through these law, statutes, commandments. That's how you know how to live, man. All right? That's how you show your reverence, your fear, because you do the things that he asks, all right?
He says, "For surely there is an end, and thine expectations shall not be cut off."
Oh, real quick, and that fear is that reverence for the Lord, man. That's what it's going into, reverence to him, man.
Right. All right,
go back to
that. I'm going to start
back
at the top.
Okay.
Proverbs 23:17 says, Let not thine heart envy sinners, and be thou in the fear of the Lord all day long.
Right.
Because for surely there is an end, and thy expectation shall not be cut off.
That's right. Hey, because there's going to be an end, as it says through the prophets, man, through Yahweh Shemeshah's prophets, man, that, hey, this place is going to come to naught, man, and it shall not tarry, man, all right? The Lord is going to do what he says he's going to come to do, man,
right.
All right? He's not a man that he shall lie, all right?
It's an envy or not, man. We're not supposed to wrong what they want, these things that they got, man,
right.
All right? Who cares that you got a so-called cussing habit? I'm going to broke down on the side of the road.
That's right.
Who cares about these beings that you got? Who cares about the 4th of July staking feast that you guys do, man?
Yeah.
All right? I'm not supposed to be on those things, but I'm not supposed to be on the fear of Yahweh Shemashah.
That's right.
reverence you have about Shimon O'Shea, man.
That's right. Yeah. Instead, Jake rather, as we're seeing here at this park, man, they rather reverence the oppressor, man. Right. They want to be in the Star Spangled Banner outfit, man. You know what I'm saying? They're showing out, man. All right, but they're showing out for the wrong cause, man. All right, and they're going to be put out.
Well, that's another trick that the so-called Esau do, man. Right. They keep coming over these holidays because Jake is the biggest consumer.
Yeah. That's right.
All right, so Jake thinks they get a Juneteenth or the 4th of July. Jake ought to spend their whole check on this stuff.
That's right.
Don't worry about it, baby. We'll pay here 3 weeks from now.
That's right. But we're going to show out and we're going to blow the block up, man.
Wow. All right.
See, Esau keeps asking these holidays too, because you know Jake's gone, man.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? And it's between Jake. See, Esau puts stuff out there because you know Jake will follow him.
That's
Jake away from the power, Esau's gonna do it, man. That's right. Now, Esau, when he comes out and says, you know what, this holiday is wicked, guess what, Jake is finally taking word for it and only doing it. Yeah, that's right. You know, that's right. Yeah, and they trust more in man than they do the Lord, man. That's right. You know, and you know, Esau, man, they do all these studies and stuff. They know Jake likes to party and bullshit, man.
You know, which equals more money. They're going to spend, hey, Jake going to buy the $1,000 bottle, man, just to show out for one day. All right? Hey.
Jake ain't buying no $1,000 bottle. Oh, I thought you said Bible.
No. Bottles.
Yeah.
No. Oh, yeah, $1,000 bottles, not Bibles. Yeah,
well,
we know that.
Let you know where our mind is. What? Our mind is concentrating on the word.
That's right. Right. That's right.
I thought you said Bible.
Yeah.
I got a precept.
This is Psalms chapter 62, verse 4. They only consult to cast him down for his excellence. They delight in lies. They bless with their mouth, but they curse inwardly to lie.
That's right. See, hey, man. Hey, like these wicked elites, man. Hey, they love to see Jake go off, man, because they, you know, these elites know that their time is coming to an end. So the only thing they're trying to do is they're trying to stretch that time, you know. They're trying to push the time further and further back, man. And a good movie to see right now is on Amazon Prime called The Tomorrow War, man. All right. You know, if y'all check that out, man, it's about an alien invasion, but they keep trying to travel back and forth in time to keep stopping it, but the time keeps moving. You know, ultimately, they got some bullshit at the end, but it's inevitable, man. That's what it's coming down to, man. This place will be destroyed, man. Fuck it. We'll go back to that, man. Please go back to that.
Yeah, real. Psalm chapter 62, verse 4. They only consult to cast him down from his excellence.
They only gather together, man, to see the downfall of Jake. You see that in Psalm, what, the 83rd chapter, man? All right. They're confederate against, Jake, man. You Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. Hey, the whole council is set up to make sure that the children of Israel don't ever rise to power, man. Because they know once that happens, man, it's over, you know?
Less than a couple of weeks ago, the last month, they had, the G7 summit.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? That's part of their council, man.
Yep.
You know?
And see, the ignorant people of the world, man, they think, they ain't worried about you, just little old Jake. But they are, because we're the ones that have the true power, man, of this world, man. All right?
Now, Jake thinks that they be getting together just to be discussing gas prices.
Right. Oh, that's true. Yeah. That's true. Yes.
They delight in lies. They bless with their mouth, but they curse inwardly. A lot.
That's right. Hey, that's why the book of Sirach, hey, never trust thine enemy, like, man. You got that real quick? Yeah, hold on. Never trust the enemy because, man, they talk them smooth words, you know, they act like, but they're inwardly the ravaging wolves, man. You got that too. Brothers, okay, go ahead, get that.
Okay. This is the book of Sirach for Ecclesiastes.
Oh, hold on. He got a little bit more. No, go ahead, get a little bit more. Yeah.
My soul, wait thou only upon Yahweh Bashem Elishah.
That's right.
For my expectation is from him.
That's right. See, That's how the men of the Lord need to be thinking, man. Hey, our expectations aren't in this world. Hey, our expectations is Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, man. That's where we're reaching for salvation and the guidance, all right? We're not looking at the rest of the world go against these scriptures, man, and think that they're onto something. Nah, man. They're in complete darkness, man, and madness, man. So, hey, just like David, man, you're going to trust in Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, man. So, likewise, we are too. All right? You got it on that baby? Okay.
Okay. This is the book of Ecclesiasticus or Sirach, chapter 12, verse 10. And it reads, "Never trust thine enemy, for like as an iron ruster, so is his wickedness."
You know, and we could have read it wrong, but it said never trust thine enemy, or does it say sometimes trust them?
What's never.
Never.
So never.
Never means never, man. Hey, matter of fact, get the definition for never. Let's see what it comes over with. So, yeah, the scriptures say never trust thine enemy. Just like as iron rusts, so is wickedness, man. We know, hey, once iron starts to rust, man, it's a guarantee that iron is eventually going to rust, man. All right?
Yeah. If I may add, while you're looking for that oxygen is what causes the iron to rust.
That's right.
And so what that's pretty much saying is, as long as he's breathing, don't trust him.
That's right. That's right.
Not ever, at no time. Not in any degree.
Okay, no matter what the situation is, you never trust the enemy, okay?
Not under any condition.
See? Don't matter, hey, if you up, down, left, or right, hey, don't ever trust thine enemy, man.
See,
okay?
When you trust your enemy, you commit to things like what's going over here at this park. See what I'm saying? Celebrating this wicked demonic holiday, then you filling your body up with abominable food.
That's why the men of the Lord, the Lord has opened up our eyes to see, man, like this, all this leads us to death, man. It's the wages of sin are death, man.
And I guarantee half these people don't even got the second round of this jab.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Yep.
Come. Just wanted to back the elder up on what he said. You know, they over there cooking those abominations and praying over it. This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 28, verse 9, and it reads, "He that turneth away his ear from hearing the law, even his prayer shall be an abomination." Okay, so you turn your away from hearing the law. You cooking those abominations, praying in the false name, which is praying to a false idol. So when you think you're praying to the Most High, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, you're not. You know, it's an abomination. He doesn't even hear your prayers. Okay? Just like the scriptures say, you know, he hears not the prayers of the sinner. All right? All right.
This is the book of Amos, chapter 5, verse 21. I despise your feast days, and I will not smell in your solemn assemblies. Right, man. So y'all, you know, cooking up all these abominations, you know, all this pork, you know, for the 4th of July, man, the Lord not dealing with that, all right? It says, though ye offer me burnt offerings, and your meat offerings, I will not accept them, right, man? Because y'all cooking, y'all grilling abominable foods, man. Y'all consuming foods that the Lord strictly commanded us not to consume, all right? It says, neither will I regard the peace offerings of your fat beasts. Mm-hmm. Right, man? So the Lord is not going to regard any of your sacrifices, all right? Mm-hmm. Like the brother just went into, he that turns his ear from the law, even his prayer shall be an abomination. Y'all out here cooking all these abominations, man, the Lord ain't dealing with that.
That's right.
Yeah, appreciate it. That's right, turning from the law, man. Hey, law is being talked about for a moment, right? Alright, so you people that hear the words of your heart, watch your shine, still do what you want to do, man. Don't turn around and pray to the Lord, man. You're wasting your time.
Yeah.
Because right. you don't even want to fear and take your feet to the wall, man.
Right.
Right?
That's right. This is 2 Corinthians 6 and 17.
Wherefore come out from among them, and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you. So like the brother just said, you know, they cooking all those abominable things, you know, celebrating these holidays, all right? The Lord's not dealing with that, all right? But he's, you know, he's telling you to come out, you know, be separate, all right? And he's going to deal with you. He will receive you, okay?
That's right. Because how are you going to come separate? We're not talking about, well, I'm not going over his house no more. We're talking about stopping doing the ways that they do.
All right? Here for that moment.
That's right. Right? That's right.
It's 17, chapter 17. I'm going to start at verse 14. It says, notwithstanding, they were not hear but harden their neck, as for the necks of their fathers, that did not believe in the Lord their power. And they rejected the statutes of the covenant that he made with their fathers, because the Lord taught our people not to be celebrating the worship of any other God.
Right.
But you see what our people are doing. Like you said, we hear the part, you know, brothers always come to, and we got Jacob over here, our people, Israelites, over here. The women, out of order, half naked, you know what I'm saying? The men, they half naked, you know what I'm saying? They wearing their women clothes. They over here grilling abominable food, celebrating a pagan holiday, praying to a demonic God. The Lord told us not to do that, man.
Sorry, man.
You know what I'm saying? Back in 2 Kings 17 and 15, and they rejected the statutes and his covenant that he made with your father, and his testimony was testified against them, and they followed vanity and became vain, and went after the heathen that were round about them. That's what they're doing, celebrating what the heathen tell them to do. That's why we broke right out earlier, running out the ways of the heathen.
Right.
To the chamber for why? The heathen lead you what? To destruction.
That's right, right.
The heathen ways of not everlasting life is what? Everlasting destruction. See, as you hear in the background, gunshot. That's what you're going to hear pretty soon. Rejecting trouble. So people like this that reject the ways of the Lord, huh?
That's right. That's right.
And it said, concerning whom the Lord had charged them, that they should not do like that.
Mm-hmm.
And they left all the commandments of the Lord, their power, and made them molten images, even two calves, and made a grove. A grove represents what? These churches.
Yep.
And I guarantee you today, these jakes went to church today. I guarantee you.
That's right.
It says, and worship all the hosts of heaven, and serve Baal. Baal is a demon, false god.
Right.
And, got, and they caused their sons and their daughters to pass through the fire. If you got little kids running around now, the red, white, and blue ones, representing the 4th of July, out here playing and popping fireworks and eating abundant food, shrimp, crab, lobster, and pork. I guarantee the only thing right they got is hamburger patties. That's it.
That's right.
So you see the thing?
And the buns. And the buns. That's
yeah. See, that makes it
right.
And I bet you the drug dealers is the one that bought the hamburger meat.
Right.
Yeah, that's kind of expensive.
Yeah.
All the women that's on Wicked EBT, they bought the pork chops, yep. And the shrimp platters and stuff.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Crab
they might have bought the kids the popper. I bought the popsicle. They probably bought them the red, white, and blue popsicle.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? For the 4th of July. Then it said, and worship all the hosts of heaven and serve by all. And they caused their sons and their daughters to pass through the fire. And used divination and enchantment. And sold them souls into evil in the sight of the Lord to provoke him to anger.
Mm.
See what I'm saying? And that's what they're doing right now. It's one of all across the globe is they're provoking you. How about sitting out of the anger? And I guarantee you there's going to be a lot of people dying today.
That's right.
See what I'm saying? Why? Because you provoked the Lord to anger. You pissed him off. The Lord is looking down like, look at my people, man. I done delivered them out of numerous captivities. I done led them through a body of water. They still gonna serve this white man as a god. So guess what? A lot of y'all gonna die today, man.
Right.
A lot of y'all gonna choke on a pork chop bone. A lot of y'all gonna get shot in y'all face thinking it's fireworks. A lot of y'all gonna die in concrete. A lot of y'all gonna die of diseases from eating these abominations, man. Tell me.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? I told my family that last night. Yeah. I told a lot of people get shot on this holiday. Yeah. Most people think it's fireworks.
Yep.
The Lord be judged on this holiday.
Yep.
What
do
you mean, sir? Tell me, Lord be judged on this holiday, man.
I got one more verse. And it says, therefore the Lord was very angry with Israel and removed them out of his sight. There was none left but the tribe of Judah only. That's why the Lord keeps us up the land, man. Out of our homeland, Israel. See what I'm saying? Because of what? The abomination of our people, man. The Lord was angry with us, man. Yeah, that's it. Jeremiah chapter 6. You just get to the point, verse 16. Thus saith the Lord Yahweh by Shema Rashad. Stand ye in the ways and see and ask for the old path.
That's right. Hey, that's what you children of Israel, you little Latino Native America, are supposed to be doing. You're supposed to be seeking. You're seeing all this wickedness happening and it's increasing, man. All right? As the years go past, man, this place is becoming more wicked, man. Wicked, man. So you're supposed to seek the old path, man, which what? Find people that are preaching this truth, that these law, statutes, and commandments, man. Get back to these scriptures, all right? So,
it says, ask for the old path, where is the good way,
mm-hmm.
and walk there.
That's right.
And ye shall find rest for your souls, but they said, we will not walk there.
That's right, hey, and that's the children of Israel to the T, man, a rebellious house, man. All right, hey, we experience this week in, week out, man. All right, hey, you tell your these brothers and sisters, these Negroes, Latino Americans, these Israelites, man, which is actually love. We telling you, hey, stop doing this, come back. All right, we got something better than this place. All right, but they won't hearken up to it. All right, go ahead.
Hey, we get another part of this. But they said, we will not walk there. So everybody that's celebrating this weekend holiday, that's exactly what you said.
Yep.
You tell the Lord, I'm not going to walk in your ways in your statutes. I'm going to do what I want to do. I'm going to do what pleases me. I'm living my best life. It's that Lil Duval spirit.
That's right.
See what I'm saying? Go ahead, bro.
And just think about it. Yahweh Shema Rashad has a set of high holy days that we could actually honor. So it's like, and we tell you about these days. So it's like he has days for us to honor. You decide that you're gonna honor the days of Esau Edom. And we pretty much totally discard. So those are keeping these holidays. I haven't heard anybody come back and say, oh, but we also are gonna keep the Passover. But we're going to also, because
right.
you have tied your ways to Esau Edom.
That's right.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And so, of course, there's several high holy days that Yahweh Shema Rashad has given us to honor.
That's right.
You know?
That's right.
And so, a lot of our people don't know about the high holy days.
Yep.
But everyone has learned that celebrating your holidays. So you got a lot of people in church that know Christmas is a pagan holiday, but they still celebrate.
Right, yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yep.
Jeremiah chapter 6, verse 17. Also I said, watchmen over you, saying, hearken to the sound of the trumpet.
That's right, he said, watchmen over us. Hey, you're looking at these men, you know. Lord, well, we continued in the faith, but, you know, hey, right now we're watchmen, man. Hey, and elders on down, man. Hey, those are your watchmen, man. They've been out here to tell you, hey, this is going on, all right? Watch out for this, all right? When you're on your watch, man, you're supposed to be paying attention, man. All right? Whether it's good things coming, bad things, you know, you always staying in the know, man. All right? And we're doing the service. Yeah, circumspect. Yeah, doing the service for the children of Israel. Ultimately, we're here to seal the elect, all right? Right? Because also part is teaching and preaching this word, man. And we also got to condemn the two-thirds too, man, these other heathen nations, man. They all have to hear it, all right? Everybody has to get a piece, man, whether they hear it from there, man. Everybody's got to get it. They got to know, because that way the Lord can hold you accountable in that day and say, hey,
You knew this, man. Remember this time you walked past the corner of such and such boulevard? All right. Remember you said F them guys? All right. Mm-hmm. Hey, these are the things that are going to come back to remember us, man.
Okay. All right.
Go ahead,
bro.
But they said
we
will not hearken. Therefore, hear ye nations, and know, O congregation, what is among them.
Mm-hmm.
Hear, O earth. Behold, I will bring evil upon this people, mm-hmm. even the fruit of their thoughts, mm-hmm. because they have not hearkened to my words, nor to my law, but rejected
them. That's right. Hey, the Lord's law, he's going to play your mind, man. He's going to make everything hard for you because you rejected his word, man. So he's going to make this, make every, he's going to make chaos come upon you, man. All right. And make for a way for you not to escape, man. Alright, because you chose not the ways of the Lord while yet he gave you liberty to do so. Now you're going to have to reap what you sowed, man, which is destruction, man.
Right.
You know, God, death by pain, you know?
A lot of them will feel that tonight, bro.
That's right. That's right. Yep.
Verse 12, bro. To what purpose cometh there to me incense from sheep, mm. and the sweet cane from a far country? Your burnt offerings are not acceptable. Lord, your sacrifice is sweet
to me. That's right. Hey, your pork, your ribs, your shrimp cavallasa on the grill, man, right now. Hey, you celebrating these wicked holidays, man, these pagan holidays, man, are not acceptable, man. The Lord ain't good with you, man. All right. Yeah.
Verse 21. Therefore, thus saith Yahweh by Shem Al-Shai, behold, I will lay stumbling block before this people,
mm-hmm.
and the fathers and the sons together shall fall upon them. The neighbor and his friend shall perish.
That's right. You see it right now, man. Hey, people getting together celebrating these wicked holidays, man, generation upon generation, man. All right? You know, you learned what your slave master told you, man. All right? And you stuck with it, man. All right? And ultimately, the Lord had, you know, had us fall away that way, man. But right now, man, it's your time to come back, man. But ultimately, the only event left is on the stage.
Yeah.
Man, that
was right there.
That was something different. That's that bullshit, man. That's right. See what I'm saying? The Lord is not going to protect us from that, man. That's right. See what I'm saying? The Lord is not going to protect us from that, man. That's right. See what I'm saying? The Lord is not going to protect us from that, man. That's right. See what I'm saying? The Lord is not going to protect us from that, man. That's right. Then that old man, you can't talk in the bottom of the food, man. That's right. That's right. That's right. You know what I mean? And see, the Lord knows, what people are, man. So, hey, you ain't going to get away with doing stuff like that, man. A lot of men of the Lord are preaching a piece of this word.
Made a pork hot dog exploding your throat, man. That's right. 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 That
being great in this place, man. All right, so they follow behind these traditions. All right, they're vain, man. All right, that's why Jake Wilder spent $1,000 on this so-called Wicked Holiday. Or Jake go all the way out, man, when it comes to these Wicked Holidays. Yep. All right, but when you tell Jake, hey, this is a high holiday, hey, Jake, throw his hand at it, man. All right, Jake doesn't want to hear the words, Yahweh Shem Yahweh. All right, so they follow after everything that this so-called Edomites are talking, man, and celebrate this day. This idea of freedom. Jake, go out and spend his whole day in church.
I'm ready to be reporting all
Yeah, because you people have learned the ways of the heathen. You have learned these rudiments of man. All right? Hey, what they tell you, hey, you make June, so-called Juneteenth,
We're gonna make it a holiday. And what Jay do? Jay gonna got t-shirts, yep. Had marches,
yep.
All this for what, man?
Right.
All right, that's a follow up community this event. Hey, we don't want no Juneteenth holiday, right. Man. Hey, right. We got this land, man.
That's right.
All right, we want it back in blood, man. All right, that's the only way that this place is gonna be cleansed from all this bull crap and philosophies that you're talking to people, man. Right.
At a point, you know, even with Juneteenth, we still in captivity, all right? We still gotta work under somebody, pay taxes. All right, so Jake, what the hell are you celebrating for? Are you still in captivity? You're not on top, you're on the bottom. All right, Juneteenth didn't put you on top. That's just the vice of Esau to make you think you're coming up top, all right? So,
hey, this place is all polluted, man. Right now, I see a young Jake on the swing set. He got a man purse on, man. You know, he's probably about 10 years old, man. He already got a man purse, man.
So-called Jake took this case all the way to the Supreme Court. All right, but the doctor said that pretty much these laws were not meant for you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans.
Right.
So I'm not a part of this law. All right, and that's why they get away with everything that they've done to us, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Yep. We're not even considered to be a part of the law that they uphold in this wicked country, man.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yep. To back all of you this is Baruch. Chapter 3, verse 8. Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what's today? July 4th, 2021.
Mm-hmm. We are yet this day in our captivity, man. All right, we don't have our own land. We don't have our own resources, man. We don't have nothing in this country, man. Hey, everything that we got, and we still right now, hey, we're leaning on Esau, man.
Yep.
To provide us with everything, man. Jacob got their own store so they can wear the right fabrics, man.
Yep.
All right. Jay can't get the Shabbat off all the time like he needs to, man.
Uh-huh.
Right, we're still in slavery. We're still in servitude of this devil, man.
That's right.
Right, regardless of what you dumb down Negro think, because you can light a few fireworks on the so-called 4th of July, or
you drink. Where you get there from?
Right.
We ain't make that yourself.
That's right.
Or you can drive your car up the street.
Where you get your car from?
It goes back into the curses that we get put up on the man because we didn't follow your high by shot, man.
That's right.
Alright? And so if you think you get a little leg up in this place, you think you win it, man.
That's right.
That's what it is, a leg up.
Yeah.
No, that leg up is still a leg down.
That's right, right.
You know what I'm saying? Even when you think that you made it in your society, you haven't, because everything you get from your enemy, man. This is a false sense of hope, man.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Everything you get and everything you earn, you get it from your enemy, man. He just make you feel like that you're independent or living the American dream. But he the one that's supplying everything.
Yep.
He the one that's sending the seed of Yahweh. When the scripture said, my God shall supply all my needs according to riches and glory. Well, Esau is trying to fulfill that role.
That's right.
By supplying all you think. Through his wickedness.
That's right.
Not the righteous, but the wickedness, man. That's why you got Jake selling their soul and kissing other men on TV and trying to get that bag.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? school.
Yeah, because right. When Drake get an opportunity of making for that upper echelon, it'll do whatever it takes to stay at it, you know? Because they don't teach you, hey, once you start making all this X amount of money, well, you got to make your X amount of taxes. Alright, to keep that lifestyle going. You better be paying your taxes.
It ain't
just a tax.
Yeah. Oh, fuck. They ain't even worried about taxes. When Dick was in the hood, Dick didn't pay no taxes then. Dick didn't worry about taxes. Dick worried about not eating ramen noodles no more. Ramen noodles were hot dogs instead of dinner. You know what I'm saying? Living in the project, sharing clothes with your brothers and sisters. You know what I'm saying? Dick won his own. So Dick can sell his soul instead of depending on the Lord, man.
$100,000
off
a $1 million. He got $500,000.
Right.
Like the owner said, Jake pride too, man.
Yeah.
All right. We want to be the show out team for this
weekend.
So Jake, okay. Hey, you know what Jake Mass said is? I got more than that, man.
Yep. That's right.
I got more than that, man.
Yep.
You know?
Yep.
Yeah, I got
it. Baruch. 3:8. Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity, where thou hast scattered us for a reproach and a curse, and to be subject to payments according to all the iniquities of our fathers, which departed from our power.
That's right,
see?
Somebody look at that word reproach.
That's right, because hey, man. And ultimately, you notice, hey, the Lord did it to us. Yeah, he put us in this.
That's right.
You got it.
But it's hey, and if you notice, it said we in captivity. He started with our 4 points. Like I said, you go over the enemy and find project. You go all over the world, you can still find Jake in the slums, man.
Yep.
All right, we're in the slums, man.
That's right.
All right, but Jake, hey, Jake, you live in the projects.
$5,000
over the power.
Yep. No.
Jake could be in a 2-bedroom project
with a G-Wagon truck outside. Right. 80-inch screen inside. You know what I'm saying? With 4x4 inside
the
bedroom.
Yeah, that's right. Hey.
God.
I just heard it. You're right.
This is the expression of disapproval or disappointment, the accuse of something, rebuke, reprove, to scold.
Start over again.
The expression of disapproval or disappointment.
Don't get put over there by the revelation.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? We're a disappointment to these people, man. They don't look at us like royalty, man.
Right.
They disrespect us in every shape, form, and fashion they can think of. Go ahead.
Rebuke, reprove, to scold. Address in such a way as to express disapproval or disappointment, be accused of someone. A thing that makes the failings of someone or someone else more apparent.
No, it was something else you read after the first definition.
I read the synonyms to rebuke, reprove, or control, to censure or rebuke.
No, it was something else you said too. Because it made me think about Bill Cosby.
The expression of disapproval or disappointment, to censure or rebuke an offense, the accuse of someone.
So they accuse of someone. That's what they did to Bill Cosby. They accuse of him. You know what I'm saying? Lock him away. Now he's so-called free, but he's still not free. Because now he
got
to live with
the
everlasting state of contentment here in America.
That's right. That's right.
You know what I'm saying? His name is tarnished forever.
Yep.
He can go into a grocery store, people see the way Bill Cosby there at the same time. It's that man that raped all the women.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
He
got to
carry that around
forever.
Yep.
And then he saw, and then what's so bad is that, so he just got out and Esau already put him to work. He finna go on the road.
Yep.
Esau already put him to work, 89 years old.
Yep.
But it ain't the work like you think it is.
Wow.
It's gonna be, what he gonna have to do is he gonna have to go around and be a spokesman
yep.
for the abusing and raping women.
Me too.
Like they did, like they did Mike Vick. Watch. Yep. You know what I'm saying? We're going to have to go around and give speeches and stuff, man.
Yep.
Since you said that that everlasting stand of contempt, here's some more synonyms. It's to blame, discredit, or disgrace.
Discredit.
Yep.
To blame, discredit, and disgrace. And then what they did to him, and then what they did to our people as a nation. Because look, anything that happened, what they do, they blame Israel. Just like with that dude from the NFAC. They tried to say he was a Hebrew Israelite, and he was.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Just like with the New Jersey stabbing. They tried to say they was Hebrew Israelite, and they wasn't. They tried to do anything to blame and discredit us.
That's
right. And then what both guys doing, trying to blame and discredit us.
Yep.
See what I'm saying? Go ahead.
That's what
matter of fact, hold that and get your feet set right quick. I'm going to give it back to y'all.
This is Revelation chapter 12, verse 10. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is come salvation and strength in the kingdom of our power and the power of his Hamashiach. For the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before our power day and night.
What are you doing? Esau, right. Look at your people over there. Your Bible tell them not to learn the ways of the heathen, but look at what they're doing.
That's
what they do when they tell you you're coming into their part of their upper echelon, man. Yeah. All right, when you call yourself being a so-called entertainer in the so-called world, man, all right, you your lineage go back to Israel, man, they're not going to let you go off the world unless those attributes that they chose to happen to you. All so-called Negro celebrities, man, they get drug to the north, man. Right? All right? One way or other, they wait till you die to do it, or you can't tell why you're living, man.
Yeah. You discredit and dishonor yourself so that you put your hand on that Judas curse. You understand? Because you got to lose your integrity to get this money, man. Yep. Everybody thought Tupac was so hard. I thought Tupac was a hard, down-to-earth, you know what I'm saying, brother against the white man and the government and then you see the photo circulating him, butt naked and tub with jewelry all over, posing like a bra.
Right.
See what I'm saying? Yeah, his credit is shot. Then you see him laid up in the bed with Money B from Digital Underground. His credit is shot. See what I'm saying? That's how they do all these entertainers, man. That's why they say do something strange for a piece of change. Yeah. Where do you think that come from?
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? It ain't talking about these women out here, these hoes out here blowing rods and stuff for a blown sandwich. No, it's talking about even you men in this industry.
That's right.
See what I'm saying? You want to try to for a piece of change because you want that Bentley with the stars in the roof.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
This is Matthew chapter 16, verse 26. For what is a man profited if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Right. But what shall a man give in exchange for his soul?
Death.
Right.
The wages of sin is death.
That's right.
That's what he give in exchange for his soul, man. To be on Instagram or TikTok with that big old stack of money, kick it in his Gatorade bottle just to sit there and say, you know what I'm saying? Just to say that you bought it. You know what I'm saying? But you done sold yourself before you go. So what y'all gonna do when a dollar collapses and bring the chips? What y'all gonna do then? Y'all gonna be out here blowing around and say, hey, chance from your chip to my chip. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That ain't gonna happen. You know what I'm saying? These niggas are dumb, man.
I got a precept to back you up.
Yeah, go ahead, buddy.
This is Proverbs 14 and 12. There is a way which seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death.
See, they think, I'm going to put my hood on. I'm going to put my niggas on. You know what I'm saying? I get on, I'm going to put them on. Now, I know you got to get your booty hole blown wide. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Put your niggas on. You know what you do? You know, you find another sucker to come in and get it, booty hole, blue wide, just to get these FRA notes.
Yep.
These fake dollars, man. Yep. Just you get you a new saying. Right. You know what I'm saying? The color look like Jesus said, color look like cooked crap.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Just you could be like them, man. Be like Moneybagg Yo and all these other rappers out here, man.
Yep.
Not knowing these dudes have to sell their souls.
Right.
They didn't make it off of pure talent for rap, man. They made it off of pure talent for rapping. They looked around Mr. Hershiser's rock.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's just the truth of the matter, man. You get what I'm saying? Now, that's some bars for you.
That's right. Go ahead.
There we go. Read that to him, bro.
Read it again. Yeah. It's the book, Baruch, chapter 3, verse 8. Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity.
Oh, see, so that Juneteenth is out the window.
Yep.
I said, we are yet to say in our captivity, man.
Yep.
What is captivity mean? You're a slave. You're
right.
A bondage. You know. Right. There you go. Say it again, bro.
Independence Day is out this window
there
as well.
You go.
There you go. That's right.
And that behold is like, it's to look, to observe. Like, look at the state that we're in right now. You know?
Yeah. Well, if you want to behold and observe, just turn right around.
Yep. All right. Hand the camera, bro.
Quick, just like how the Lord started Ezekiel, the state of Israel over here in America, man.
Dry bones.
Like in the dry bones. So they just getting fed out of their heritage. You know, they're not knowing who they are. You know, they're doing all this wickedness. They're going off. You know, they're celebrating these holidays. You know, hey man, people are feasting.
That's right, bro.
Yeah,
that's
right. They torch off their cooking oil, they got more moisture than they
do. Right, that's right.
More moisture than they do spiritually, man.
That's right. That's right.
Jerry, bro.
This Jeremiah 18:15, it says, because my people have forgotten me, they have burned incense to vanity, they have caused them to stumble in their ways from the ancient past, to walk in paths in a way not cast up. Right, and that's what our people doing. They're walking in all these different times because they forgot y'all about shit all the time. All right, they forgot the ancient days, man. Like they, you know, dude, I ain't got popping up fireworks, celebrating that 4th of July, man. We got put up that tree, doing all that wickedness, man. That wasn't our way, man.
Okay.
You know, that wasn't a part of our heritage, man.
Okay.
All right, hey, but through the spirit of y'all about shit all the time, all right, you put that spirit back on this man, man. To follow the ancient ways, man. All right, and to speak up while we follow them and teach our people that.
That's right, man. That's
right. Which is good. Go back to the ancient days. Man, we do it.
Woo!
Some color. Biggest bone we can find. What's their heads, man?
Yeah, like the two brothers. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead and pitch it out.
Baruch 3, verse 8. Behold.
Y'all got it back after you.
Behold. We are yet this day.
Nah, man, because it pisses you off, man. To see your people in that state of mind thinking they're doing something right now. This is 2021. Who don't know that pork is an abomination? July is wicked, man.
Right.
This ain't like it back in 1985. This is 2021, man. Go ahead, bro.
Where thou hast scattered us for a reproach and a curse.
Yeah, curse. We are under the curses, man. That's why everything Jake put his hands in fails, man.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? Go ahead.
To be subject to payment.
Don't they pay bills? Shit, they had to go buy this abomination from Esau. This 4-week-old pork, man.
Right, right.
Yeah, they try to take the green inside by putting that dye on there to make it look pink and fresh.
Yep.
But it's 4-week-old meat, man. Worms all in it, man. They out here grilling and eating it, man. Thinking they doing something.
Yeah.
TK Junior's, you show me. You got that grill smoking,
don't
you? You know what I'm saying?
Hey, smoking,
cuz. Yeah, look, Larry, my little junior, man. What is me here? Big mama, what you want? I'll give me 2 pork chops.
Right.
Make sure you give me some green with a little hog maw in it.
Yeah, all right.
You know, my sugar acting up, but hey, I'm covered by blood and cheese.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey, bro, they showed you that movie, bro. Soul food. They put all those bobbleheads at the table. Then Big Mama got her leg cut off.
No, maybe she burnt her hand.
Yeah, oh yeah, she burnt her hand.
Big Mama,
ain't nothing but a little salve can't cure.
My herbs can't cure.
Ain't nothing but a little something my ties and herbs can't cure. Then they mama gonna get her leg cut off and die. And what they do? They celebrate Big Mama's death by putting more abominations on the table.
But look, they came on bigger than Big Mama.
Yeah.
They had double everything, man.
Yeah,
double catfish, double pork chops.
Man.
They had about 80 pork chops on the table.
and this is one of the funniest. Who was sitting there with him? The damn rapper.
Wow, we get at him. Thank you, Lord, for these beautiful breasts. Under the table, on the table.
Hold this here.
And to be subject to payment according to all the iniquities of our fathers.
So, subject
to payment. That's what? You paying taxes, you paying bills. You don't own nothing over here. For all you so-called sovereign Israelites, who you buy the land for? You see what I'm saying? You had to go to your enemy to get the land.
That's right.
You see what I'm saying? So you still in captivity, man. When you get up tomorrow and go to the gas station, who you getting the gas from? When you go to work and ain't got no food, and you got to get snacks out the vending machine, where you think you're getting it from? Where you think you're getting the money to get the food out the vending machine?
That's right.
You're getting it from your enemy, man. Thank you. Say it again.
You didn't say it out.
Your face is on the money.
That's right.
It's your way to us, you know what I'm saying? You got to preach on the front of the $5 bill. With her burger you hear and her freshly perm eyelash.
Which departed from Yahweh, our power.
Yeah, and as an example, they're departing from the Lord now. Everybody's doing this for July. That's an example of you departing from the Lord, man.
That's right.
The Lord didn't tell you to celebrate 4th of July and pop fireworks and eat pork and shrimp crab and lobster. The Lord said, follow me.
That's right.
See what I'm saying? Matter of fact, I mean, I appreciate the big deal of our truth. This is the vow that Israel made to the Lord. This is the book of Ezra in the Bible, where the prophets are part of the Bible too. But you know what I mean. The book of Ezra chapter 10, verse 11, it says, now therefore make confession unto the Lord power of your fathers, and do his pleasure, and separate yourself from the people of the land and from the strange wives. The same wives are talking about the people, but also too, people correlate that with the doctrine, you know what I'm saying, the philosophy, and we can handle that. That's how it's a strange wife. And it says, then all the congregation answered, come at Israel as a nation, then all the congregation answered and said, with the loud voice, because you know Jake speaks loud in the mud.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying, like you're them old country town. What's up, hey, what's up, Fry? What's going on, man? You know what I'm saying, loud as hell. Then all the congregation answered and said with a loud voice, as thou hast said, so must we do. That's a vow Israel made to the Lord. That's why you're in the position you're in there, because you're supposed to get God, man.
Sure.
You see what I'm saying? You lied to the Lord, basically.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
But I want to add, I was brought up the definition of that. If you're about that subject, it says to cause or force to undergo a particular experience or form of treatment, to bring a person or country under one's control. All right, and that's what they do. They brought us under their control, man.
Mm-hmm.
It says typically by force.
See?
All right, and that's you're subject to that payment by force. You can't stop a government taking taxes out of your check.
Nope.
You can't stop them from taking. They come up with new stuff, FICA. They just came up with that a few years ago. That's an extra thing they're taking out of their check. You're paying into a Social Security that they're saying every day on so-called losing going to fail.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Now, FICA, well, FICA is, it is a Social Security, but it's a legal, mandatory Social Security.
Right.
Not only are you paying your regular Social Security, FICA is another Social Security set up where you basically paying for everybody else's Medicaid and Medicare also. It's mandatory. You can't get around it.
It said, that's why I say under one's control or the jurisdiction, typically by force, mandatory. You can't get around it. There ain't nothing you can do. All right, that's why we still under this devil. He got us still under mandatory servitude, man.
Right.
All right, no matter if we working for this devil, we paying us low level money,
All right, and then he's turning around and still taking his piece before we even get off.
Yep.
And don't forget about the jab, man.
That's true.